So this year for my birthday, I got myself a little present. I think it's well deserved. Do I need it? No. Did I want it? Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Flip a coin. Do you have a coin? It's just like, I heard the look is just so different. It's kind of like the next grade up in terms of production. I don't like this coin. I don't want to look at it.
Heads I get it, tails I don't.
God. This company made a decision to drop their prices. Couldn't pass it up, to be honest. I did it. Yo, this thing is tiny. Just like the C300, the R3, all my cameras. I never rented it or even used them before. I just kind of went out and bought them. Look at it compared to the R3. Like, look at that. That's insane. The most annoying part is the XLR cable is the most annoying part. This is awesome. It's already built in, so B mount. So I realized when I was editing this video, I don't have an ending. So I want to give some final thoughts. I just want to premise, first off, this is my first Red. This is my first time within the ecosystem. I never even shot with one before. I seen them on sets, but nothing that I was very hands-on with. So just feeling it and seeing it for the first time is definitely awesome. I was super surprised about how small it is. But right off the gate, I had a few issues with, let's start with power. These are V-mount batteries that I use. This is the 98 micro, travel friendly and everything. I thought, you know, it's a V-mount, it should just pop right in and work. It didn't work, so luckily I just plugged in the DC power that it came with and went into the menu, and then I saw that the voltage coming in was just a little bit higher than this puts out. I feel like that setting should be already kind of set, wouldn't you think? All right, let's talk about the lenses. Actually, let's take a step back. When you buy a Red, it just comes with the body. I knew that going into it. I figured I have so much gear that, you know, I can just kind of plug in all the spare parts that I have. But there's a few things I don't have. So first off, I need a cage for me to mount the things that I need for it to be useful. I need a top handle, because as of right now, the only way to hold it is like this, like in my hand, which that's not safe. I need a side handle. It doesn't come with a 3-pin XLR. It comes with a 5-pin, which I get it because, well, they wanted to keep the form factor small. So I need to get a converter for the XLR. I read that it takes CF Express Type B, which all my cameras do. It can't read the SanDisk 512 card. Well, I have two SanDisk CF Express Type Bs. And then I have two Delkin ones. So it could read the Delkin. Let me show you guys. Well, also watch this. 3, 2, 1, and start. Damn, but come on. For sure, like that's kind of ridiculous. Okay, so back to what I was saying. It recognizes the Delkin. but it gives this warning. Here's a Delkin. It's in there, it reads it, it sees it, right? When I eject that card, which you have to like eject it in the menu, kind of found that kind of weird, kind of like when you're ejecting a hard drive on a PC. So SanDisk goes in, first off nothing, and let's just hit nothing. It knows something's in there. I can't even format it, which is also very frustrating. So yeah, make that make sense. I gotta figure out my whole storage and memory media situation. The RF mount lock is really, really kind of tight, which again, that's the purpose of it, right? Is to make sure your lenses don't fall out. But dang, when I try to take off my adapter earlier, I felt like I was ripping or unthreading something. Let's end this on a good note. A few things. I love the fact that it's small. Trust me, the C300 Mark III is a beast of a camera, but it gets heavy. When it gets fully rigged and you're running around all day, that's a mammoth to endure. This one's nice and compact. I really like the interface. Very, very smooth, intuitive. Again, I haven't really taken the time to kind of go through all the menus and everything like that, but it seems to me like everything is relatively just in the right spot. What I'm really interested in is red code. Apparently you can really fine-tune and change a bunch of things in post. I'm interested in seeing how massive the storage files are, which I'm assuming it's gonna be huge. Unboxing experience, like I said, with all those hiccups, I'll give it a 5 out of 10, pending on the overall experience with it, because I just haven't shot with it yet. But we'll see. Anyways, I know this is a late post. I've been doing this 30-day challenge. This would technically be day 4. Basically, I'm gonna be posting every single day for 30 days. Time is gonna vary because these next 30 days are pretty hectic for us. Ton of different shoots. Gonna be a huge game of time management and staying organized. I hope you guys learned something new. Save this for later, share it with a friend, and I'll see you tomorrow.